In our today's lecture, we are going to discuss the next point of this chapter is variation of molar conductivity with concentration. Now students, in our last lecture, we have seen the problems which are related or which shows the relation between K and lambda, that is conductivity and molar conductivity. Now, variation of molar conductivity with concentration with strong electrolytes and weak electrolytes we are going to discuss. The variation of molar conductivity with concentration in case of strong and weak electrolyte is qualitatively different. Now, in our next point, we are going to discuss in detail. The molar conductivity of solution of strong electrolyte increases rapidly with dilution. Now, what does it mean? Means when molar conductivity we are going to measure for a corresponding solution of strong electrolyte, it increases rapidly with dilution. Means the curve which we are going to plot is which shows the variation will be like this. Means this curve, if you look at for strong electrolytes, now here I will explain this graph in short. Students, look at this graph. It shows lambda versus square root of C, means molar conductivity versus concentration. Students, if we move from left to right on x-axis, we should understand that square root of C like a dilution. Means if we move from left to right, concentration goes on increasing. But if we move from right to left, then concentration gets decreases. What does it mean? Means if we want to study this graph for molar conductivity for strong electrolytes, then the square root of C value will goes on increasing if we move from right to left. When we move from right to left on y-axis, you will get the graph which increases in straight line manner and which goes on increasing for strong electrolytes. Now students, another graph which we have plotted here by the observations for weak electrolytes, it will increase exponentially. And students, one thing you will notice here in this graph, it will not touches to the y-axis. What does it mean? Because for the observation, the electrolyte which we have taken is of weak electrolyte. For weak electrolytes, dissociation will not take place 100%. So we will not get a perfect value on the y-axis. And if we look at its extension, it will goes on parallel with the y-axis, but it will not touch to the y-axis. Means we cannot get the exact value for weak electrolyte. That is lambda zero value for weak electrolyte we will not get. But for strong electrolytes, it will intersect to the y-axis, and the point where the intersection will takes place, that point we are calling it as a lambda zero. Now that lambda zero is nothing but what? The molar conductance at infinite dilution, or we can say zero concentration. So this is the meaning of this graph or the curve which we have plotted here. Now students, the theory for the same curve is given here for strong electrolytes and for weak electrolytes. So both the explanations we are going to look at here in the theoretical manner in this case. The molar conductivity of solution for strong electrolytes increases rapidly with dilution that we have seen in this plotted graph. And the thing the next they have explained is nothing but it approaches the limiting value for 0.001 molar to 0.0001 molar solution. The dilution has no effect on molar conductivity thereafter. the maximum limiting value of molar conductivity is the molar conductivity at zero concentration, or we can say at infinite dilution. Both the words has the same meaning. You can either say zero concentration, or you can also use this word infinite dilution. Both has the same meaning. It is denoted by the lambda zero. The zero concentration or infinite dilution means the solution is so dilute that the further dilution does not increase the molar conductivity. Now, here is the scientist Kohlrausch, F. Kohlrausch, during 19th century, with repeated experiments, he has showed that the molar conductivity for strong electrolytes varies linearly with square root of concentration as given below. Now, students, this equation 5.10, which tells us that A is the constant for strong electrolyte, and the plot which I have explained earlier, which shows the detailed information of the behavior of strong electrolytes and weak electrolytes. And for weak electrolytes, students, and in this curve, I already explained, you will get a sharp and linear curve for strong electrolytes, but for weak electrolytes, you will get a exponential curve. Now, students, we are going to look at the weak electrolytes and its nature on the curve. Now, students, the molar conductivity of weak electrolytes increases rapidly on dilution for concentrations of 0.001 molar or 0.0001 molar. The lambda value, that is molar conductivity value, is lower than that of the lambda zero. The molar conductivity at zero concentration. For weak electrolytes, the variation of lambda versus square root of C, which shows the figure 5.1, is not linear, that I already explained here, which is in exponential manner. Now, students, which shows that the molar conductivity for strong electrolytes at zero concentration can be determined by extrapolating of linear part of lambda versus square root of C curve, as shown in the figure which we have explained earlier. This method cannot be used for weak electrolytes, since lambda versus square root of C curve does not approach linearity. Kohlrausch law is useful for calculating lambda zero of weak electrolytes. Now, students, with the help of this value, means by using Kohlrausch law, we can determine the lambda zero values for weak electrolytes, and how that we are going to look at in the applications of Kohlrausch law in detail. Now, what does it Kohlrausch law explains to us? Kohlrausch law of independent migration of ions, that now we are going to discuss. The law states that at infinite dilution, each ion migrates independent of co-ion and contributes to total molar conductivity of an electrolyte irrespective of the nature of both ion to which it is associated. Now, what does it mean? For example, if you have an electrolyte, that electrolyte, if it is a strong electrolyte, it will dissociate as, suppose I have taken an example of NaCl, it will dissociate as Na plus and Cl minus. Now, that Na plus and Cl minus, that we are calling it as a ions. Now, if I apply this Kohlrausch law to that ions, according to its statement, at infinite dilution, each ion migrates independent of co-ion, means the migration of Na plus and Cl minus ions takes place, but how its nature would be, it would be they migrates independent of its co-ions. And if you are going to measure the total molar conductivity of an electrolyte, then at that time the additions of both that Na plus and Cl minus ions, that is their molar, they contribute to the total molar conductivity of an electrolyte irrespective of the nature of the other ion. So this is the Kohlrausch law which we are going to apply for different electrolytes. Now, students, both cation and anion contribute to the molar conductivity of the electrolyte at zero concentration, and Thus, lambda 0 is the sum of molar conductivity of cation and that of the anion at zero concentration. And that can be manipulated with the help of equation 5.11 that tells us that lambda 0 is equal to means molar conductivity at zero concentration or at infinite dilution will be equal to the n plus lambda 0 plus means what does it means? Lambda 0 plus means the cation and the molar conductivity of that anion at zero concentration, and that is the same meaning for the negative ions, molar conductivity at zero concentration for negative ions. Now students, what does n plus and n minus represents? This represents the number of moles of cation and anion specified in a chemical formula of electrolyte. So this is the meaning of the terms which we are going to use for calculation of molar total molar conductivity at infinite dilution for a specific electrolyte. Now this is the equation that is Kolderash law. According to Kolderash law, he has explained by doing some observations. Now students, in the next point we are going to discuss the applications of Kolderash theory. Now out of different applications, one of the application is now we are going to see. The theory can be used to calculate the molar conductivity of an electrolyte at the zero concentration, for example, for KCl and for barium hydroxide, that is BaOH twice. We are going to apply or we are going to use this formula which we have explained earlier. For KCl, if you want to apply, then it would be like this. Lambda 0 for KCl is nothing but is equal to lambda 0 of K plus plus lambda 0 of Cl minus. Now students, this is the capital lambda which we have used with the KCl, and at the equal to side, at the right hand side of the equation, lambda 0 which we have used is the small lambda, and the lambda which we have used at left hand side of the equation, lambda 0, that represents the capital lambda. Now students, for barium hydroxide we have used the same equation, and for barium hydroxide we have applied that equation, so that equation would be appear like this. Lambda 0 of Ba2 plus plus 2 into, what does it do? Means the OH hydroxide ions which are present here are in number 2, so therefore the 2 we are using it as a coefficient, so 2 multiplied by lambda 0 of OH minus ions it becomes. By knowing the molar conductivities of ions at infinite dilution, lambda 0 values for electrolyte can be obtained. Now students, in this first application, what we are going to be calculate is nothing but the total molar conductance at zero concentration for KCl. So we should know about for individual ions, means lambda 0 for individual ions, if we know, then we are going to calculate the total molar conductance. So that for Kolderash formula which is useful for the calculation of lambda 0 of KCl. So this is the first application of this Kolderash. Now students, in our next lecture we are going to look at for the next remaining applications in the next lecture. Thank you very much.